When I started with amateur television in the 80s, cameras were unaffordable. My first ATV transmissions were with a TRS-80 computer as a video source. Through an advertisement, I exchanged my 2-meter band transverter for a security camera with monitor. The camera, I don't remember the brand, turned out to be connected with a multipole cable to the monitor without a video out connection. With an oscilloscope and research, I came up with a circuit that allowed me to extract video and therefore transmit black and white camera images. A little later, I exchanged my 70 cm transverter for an Akai camera that has a video output connector. That video was also black and white. As a light sensitive instrument, these cameras uses a vidicon, a tube that was not very sensitive in artificial light and gives less and less contrast over time. Also not really suitable for portable use. It was great when CCDs came available, directly in color. I then donated the Akai monitor to an online museum in England, the link to which is mentioned below. My first camera with CCD was a Sony 8mm video camera with a defective recorder. Later a Sony photo camera that could put images on floppies. These types of cameras are still fine as a video source for ATV transmitters. Later I also used other digital photo cameras, such as the Canon PowerShot or the Ixus. As long as there is a way to get video from the device, usually recognizable by the yellow Tula plug of a connection cable. Just keep in mind that such a camera sometimes switches off automatically after a while, then the image goes to black. Another advantage of cameras as a video source is that they can also show pre-recorded images, handy for generating test images or an ATV activity weekend, for example. Another possibility is a cheap, lightweight video camera from China. The model used here has infrared LEDs that illuminate the object when it is dark. This means that the camera itself is also sensitive to infrared light. The colors are therefore somewhat dull. To improve this, it is easy to place an infrared filter, which is for example removed from a defective camera, in this case a Sony. Simply place the filter in front of the CCD or the lens and the colors will be more realistic. Then of course the camera will no longer work in the dark and the LEDs can be removed to save energy. That energy can easily be obtained from a battery or power supply. No empty batteries or battery packs as with a photo camera. Sometimes other ex-CCTV cameras are offered, which are also very suitable for ATV. Just like the cheap cameras from China, you have to manually focus on the subject if it is too close to the lens. Nowadays there are many possibilities to get these cheap video sources. Just ask around with family or friends, look at flea markets or the second-hand store. Don't forget to subscribe for free to my channel if you are curious about my next video. Until next time!